Rebecca again. I'm so glad that you've tuned into the Kingdom Kids Puppy Show today.
Hi, everyone.
Each week this summer, we're taking a closer look to find out what it means to have faith.
Faith is trusting in what you can't see because of what you can see.
Let's look at this microscope, for example. Microscopes help us see very small things that we can't see with just our eyes. We have to look through a special lens to see them as if they were bigger.
Even though we can't see God, we can still put our faith in Him. Faith is like that special lens.
We can trust Him no matter what. We can focus on all the things God has done for us in the past. And we can also see what He's done in the lives of others. That helps us trust Him.
This week, we're going to learn about Saul, also known as Paul, going through an amazing transformation after an encounter with God. Let's watch the Bible lesson for this week.
The Bible. It's 66 books of history, stories, letters, and poetry that fit together to form God's one big story. The epic adventure of how He created us and loves us so much that He made a way to rescue us. As we travel through the Bible, from Genesis to Revelation, we discover people who met God and found their lives changed forever. Now for an amazing story, inspired by the book of Acts, chapter 9, verses 1 through 9.
If anyone was set up for the good life, it was Saul of Tarsus.
Greetings.
Though Saul's family was Jewish, he was also born a Roman citizen. Throughout his life, he was known by two different names.
You may call me Saul or Paul.
As a young man, Saul was sent to Jerusalem to study with the famous Rabbi Gamaliel.
Let's see. You have achieved 100% in classical literature, 111% in philosophy, and in ethics, 99%.
Oh, I vow to do better.
Saul became a Pharisee like his father before him. He carefully studied God's law and prayed 3 times a day.
Dear God, help me follow your laws 100% perfectly.
Like the other religious leaders in Jerusalem, though, Saul was caught off guard by the events that surrounded the life and death of Jesus.
Good riddance. Now that fool can't try to overturn God's laws anymore.
Haven't you heard? Jesus' follower says he's returned to life.
They've seen Jesus?
They've seen Jesus.
Oh, those riffraff will slink away soon enough.
Against all odds, the followers of Jesus didn't fade away. In fact, the numbers began to grow.
5,000? You're telling me that 5,000 people are following the way of a dead man?
Well, technically, they think he's alive.
Not helping.
The religious leaders in Jerusalem did everything they could to squash the new movement. They even arrested a leader among the Jesus followers named Stephen. After telling lies about him, they dragged him outside the city.
This man is a disgrace.
Saul stood by and held the coats of the men who picked up stones and threw them at Stephen until they killed him.
If Stephen had just let go of this Jesus nonsense, he wouldn't have had to die.
It's terrible. I heard people are following the way of Jesus in other cities too.
What? Inconceivable.
Saul quickly became known for hunting down people who believed in Jesus. When he discovered that some Jews in Damascus were following Jesus, he went straight to the high priest.
This Jesus thing is spreading everywhere.
I'm aware.
They think he's alive.
Hashtag, yup.
Someone should do something.
I hope you have something constructive to say.
Give me letters to the synagogues in Damascus so I can arrest all the believers and bring them back here.
Now you're talking.
Saul set off for Damascus with the blessing of the high priest. He traveled with a group of men to arrest the believers they found. After days on the road, they neared the city.
There it is.
We'll make it by lunch.
No, we must take time to pray.
As he did 3 times every day, Saul stopped and turned to Jerusalem to pray. Certain God was on his side.
Dear Lord, help me to catch every single one of those despicable Jesus people.
Suddenly, a light more brilliant than the midday sun blazed down around Saul. He staggered, fell to the ground, squeezing his eyes shut against the glare.
Saul. Saul. Why are you opposing me?
Saul gasped. It felt as though the whole earth shifted beneath him.
Who are you, Lord?
I am Jesus. I am the one you are opposing.
The men around Saul stared in horror and confusion, unable to speak. They could see no one, but heard a sound, perhaps like a roar of thunder.
Now get up and go into the city. There you will be told what you must do.
Saul reeled. He struggled to his feet and finally opened his eyes. He saw nothing, only darkness.
What? What's happened?
You tell us. We saw the light, and you fell, and this sound, and then you said—
I can't see.
What?
I can't see. I've been blinded.
That's not good. Here, take my hand.
Saul grasped the man's hand and shuffled a few steps forward.
Who are you talking to?
I think it was Jesus.
You heard Jesus?
I heard Jesus.
Saul's companions led him into Damascus, where he stayed at the home of a man named Judas on Straight Street.
Want something to eat?
I'm not hungry.
Or water?
Not thirsty.
For 3 days, Saul wrestled with himself and God. He'd come face to face with the very man he knew was dead, but discovered that Jesus was very much alive. Now blind, Saul was forced to see everything in a brand new light.
Saul had come face to face with Jesus, a man he thought for sure was dead. This means Jesus was very much alive. It meant Jesus really was who he said he was, the Son of God!
This moment changed everything for Saul. He was forced to see and understand God in a brand new way. He realized that what he had done was wrong before. He had a new mission in life. Instead of trying to keep people from following Jesus, he wanted to join them.
What was true for Saul is also true for us today. Knowing Jesus changes the way you see everything.
Exactly. Before we go, let's pray. Dear God, thank you for everything that you have done. You changed everything for Saul that day on the road to Damascus. He went from wanting to stop people from believing in Jesus to believing in Jesus himself. We know that when we put our faith in you, you change the way we see everything. Please help us to trust you and remember that you're with us through whatever we might be facing right now. We love you, and we pray these things in Jesus' name. Amen.
Thanks for coming today. See you guys next week.
Hi, guys.
Hi, guys.
Hi. See you again.
It's great to see everybody. As we're learning about seeing this week, we're learning about when Jesus appeared to Saul on the road, and Paul saw things in a completely new way. He understood that Jesus really is the Son of God. All throughout history, God has revealed himself to people and helped them understand what he's like. That was especially true when he sent Jesus. While Jesus was here, he showed people, he helped them see what God is like. He showed us how much God loves us by dying on the cross for our sins. He also showed how powerful he is by coming back to life. It's great to be with you guys again, and I hope you're all paying close attention as we learn about this today.
Thank you so much, Mr. Thorne. God used a blinding light to get Saul's attention. God can get our attention too in lots of different ways. He can help us see things in a completely new way. When you know Jesus, you can trust that he is working in your life when everything's going great, or even when things aren't going the way you thought they would.
Well, the bottom line is, knowing Jesus changes the way you see everything. So take time to focus on Jesus. So look at my glasses today. That's one example of what you can do for the contest. Remember the contest I told you guys about last week? Well, it's ongoing to the end of June. So make one of these with any materials you can find in your house, take a picture of it, and email it to me. So all the details are in our Facebook page. You will find it all there. Get your mom and dad to find it, and they will tell you exactly what you need to do and how to send it to me. All right? Oh, and one more thing. In this video, we're going to add something called a Hocus Focus game. It's just 2.5 minutes long, so watch out for it on this video and play the game. It's just something fun for you guys to do.
Thank you so much, Karen. All right, guys, it's that time again. Let's get ready to pray. Put your left hand up, put your right hand up, put them together, and our heads are down. Big breath. Heavenly Father, we thank you so much for this day. We thank you for the technology that you've given us, Lord, that has helped us to come together, even though we are supposed to be apart right now. Lord, we thank you for each and every child who is watching. Please bless them. Please bless the families of these children, Lord. Father, as we go into this week, help us to be mindful that you are with us and helping us to see things differently. Even when things are going the way that we want them to, and when things are not going the way that we want them to. Please help us to keep our focus on you. Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Sarah. Thank you, Nathan, for being on with us. And we'll see you guys next week. Bye.
See you.
Bye. Bye.